It's about... It's
as though a documentary crew has followed a household of vampires in Wellington, New Zealand.
Exploring their lives, finding out about their hunting habits, their just who they are, exploring who these characters are, and...
Their loves, their dreams.
Their passions, their disappointments.
Their failures.
So their hopes. Their fears. So there are three. It starts off with three or four characters in this flatting situation.
Which is it?
Well, it's three, but it's there's four. Also there's four. But it's you hardly three, ever see the fourth one. There's
a fourth as well.
Yeah. So it starts off with one, and then you introduce another one. So then there's two, and then there's like, and then the guy knocks on the door, and then you see this other one, and then another one. So there's four.
There's four. There's four vampire
flatmates.
One's played by Taika here. One's played by me and Jemaine.
The other one was played by our mate Johnny, and another one by our other friend Ben. And my character is sort of like the kind of mum of the flat. So he's just sort of like the caring vampire who just. But he's also he wants to have the flat to be clean.
He's like a 17th century dandy.
Yeah, but he's also he's pretty anal about cleanliness and things, and just pedantic. Jemaine's character
is very different.
Very different.
He used to be a very powerful warlord, sort of tyrannical master of some land.
He wrote his own backstory.
Yeah. And but now he's
now the other thing that his character's known for? Having big orgies. Mm. Huge, massive orgies with like 30
people. Formerly. Now when he has orgies, he can only get about two or three people interested.
So he's lost a lot of power.
Yeah. So that's where we meet him. Oh, for some, yeah. For some.
Are there any particular films or kind of reference points that you both kind of had when you first started talking about this?
Yes. Spinal Tap. Bad News. Zelig. They're mockumentaries. There's this one in New Zealand, Fred Dagg, about a farmer, which is pretty good. What else, Ty?
Christopher Guest movies.
Yep.
And what about on the
vampire? And vampire films.
Vampire films.
Lost Boys, Interview with the Vampire.
Nosferatu.
Let the Right One In.
Salem's Lot.
Well, I remember a film called Silver Bullet, but it must have been about werewolves, I'm sure. Yeah.
But there's werewolves in the film as well.
I like the idea of going back to the classic style vampires from, even though Interview with the Vampire is not like a really, really old film. You know, for me, it sort of feels like those are the classic, vampire, stereotypical vampires. And think today's because everyone's so used to the Twilight style vampires and sensitive vampires and vampires who are too sparkle. It was just nice to be able to embrace those old kind of Dracula style ones. That's why I enjoyed that.
Can you talk a little bit about the rest of the cast and some of the wonderful people you've got in this?
You're probably referring to Rhys Darby, who's the
wonderful guy.
Yes. Talented comedian. He plays the alpha werewolf, so he's the leader of the werewolves. He has a group of werewolves who, and he kind of guides them. There's me, there's him.
Johnny and like Ben, that. Who I mentioned before. There's actually a lot of people who had never acted before, non-actors. It's the official, just technical term. And
there's a friend of ours who's an IT guy called Stu, and he plays an IT guy called Stu.
So Stu the IT guy is actually a real Stu the IT guy?
Yeah, you could actually get him to fix your computer.
That's a nice bonus from co-stars.
IT guy turned actor turned IT guy.
Obviously fans are going to get a chance to see this wonderful film that you've made. What are you hoping they take away from doing the show?
A t-shirt, something like that.
Merchandise. Merch.
Merch.
What
would be the best item of merchandise you can imagine for this film, if it doesn't already exist?
Maybe
Hasn't been done.
Maybe a cell phone cover that looks like vampire teeth or something like that.
Picturing it.
So then you'll be weird because you have to just use your phone like this for it to work.
Just walk around.
And you wouldn't hear what they're saying. Doesn't work.
Yeah, I don't know. No idea.
I hope from the movie
like a tattoo, like full face tattoo of like our faces that you can just put on and then you lick it and then and then stick it all over your face.
It's a lot of licking.
And then it peels off and it's like my face is now on your face, so you can be me for a day.
Wow, that'd be good. And if I was you for a day, what are you guys doing next? Where could I go and impersonate you? Have you got more stuff together or
you could go and live in my house and look after my kid.
And Jemaine, if I had your face, could I do anything more exciting?
It doesn't seem to get me anywhere.
Really?
My face? No. Not by itself.